Hey guys, here's Dora from Ultimate Success Coaches. We have some light at the end of the tunnel here in the Netherlands, because as of next week, 28th of April, some open terraces will be really, really opened. Coffee places, restaurants, you name it. Only between 12 o'clock noon and 6 p.m. But whatever, at least you can go and get a coffee outside. So some positivity. This year, you just really appreciate every little piece of positive news. So that's it on the COVID update. And let's go to this running shoes May wish list. And yeah, I already mentioned, unfortunately, I'm injured. Though I got cleared for running, slowly building up jogging, I would say, as of yesterday. So that's, yeah, I'm super happy about that. But it means, of course, that in April I did not put many mileage in my running shoes. So in this running wish list for May, I wanted to give an update about three running shoes from New Balance, which I had in previous wish list videos. I will put the links above. The three running shoes is basically a really, really killer combination in your rotation. If you have these three, I think you are just covered. It's a really great lineup from New Balance. On a race shoe, that's the Fuel Elite version 2. It is open for pre-order and it will be shipping next month, so in May. So at the end, in May, you can purchase the shoe. Carbon plated, super good reviews, much more cushioned than last year, the version 1. I'm definitely interested on that one. I have to see how the races will go ahead, if there will be any races later this year, because I'm not really planning this moment to play any more plated shoes for races, because I have still my wear profile, because I have still my Saucony Pro and also the Adidas, so it's a question mark on my side, though it's really tempting because the shoe looks big, spot on. So that is the race shoe. The second is the Max Cushioning shoe, that's the More version 3, which is already in Europe at some sites, not at the official New Balance sites, but some other retailers online. I have already seen this coming in, so you can purchase that one already as well. Because just I'm getting back from the injury, I have a yes for this shoe. I definitely plan to purchase it the coming weeks. And the third in this New Balance lineup, it's not an official lineup, but I would say that it's a perfect rotation. That's the New Balance Rebel version 2, more like a lightweight daily trainer, tempo, speed shoe. And the reviews are just magnificent about this shoe. Absolutely on my agenda, maybe later in May or in June, when I can really build up my speed, work on that as well. Not only I'm super happy that I already can basically just get the basis there, so when I get build up on the speed as well, I will purchase the shoe. So this is about New Balance. This is the lineup that will be really, really complete in May. So if you have any plans to purchase these shoes, go for it. On the other hand, one new shoe that popped up on the market in April, that was the Nike Pegasus 38. And you know that I'm a huge Nike Pegasus fan, but the 37 I didn't really like, and I had several issues also with the upper and also with the cushioning on the midsole foam. Now, the bad news is that the midsole did not change, but I also heard that quite many people were really satisfied with that midsole. So maybe that was less of an issue. It was not my favorite, but people are of course different. But the good news is that the upper has been really changed. Looking forward to see that upper, and it's a really positive feedback on that from some early testers. So we'll see. To be honest, the colorway which came up as the original colorway from the 38, I don't really like, but we know Nike, there will be 10 other colorways popping up next weeks. On the other hand, I just threw away one of my Nike IDs, which was my first Nike ID shoe ever, and that was a Nike Pegasus 35. And the ID version, so the one which you can design yourself on the site, now saying that it will come for online really, really soon. So I'm super interested on that part. So if I'm purchasing this shoe, then this will be an ID version. And also I put some own designs there. I really like these designs, So the 37 in my view was quite boring, but the 38 designs, there are some good colorways, some good pre-designs there. So let's check it out. I will put also the link in the description box below. You can just click and design your own shoes. So that was my May wishlist. What is on your agenda for May? Do you have anything in mind what you would like to purchase from the current running shoe market? If you do have, please put in the comment box below. I would be super interested to hear from you. If you like the video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you are not a subscriber yet, just subscribe to the channel as well. I would really appreciate it. Thank you for watching until the end and see you in the next video. Bye!